Bible.
Amen.
If God should give you a word to discipline me, it should come from the Bible. Sins of God, one of the serious things that a lot of people does, amen, because of such and such a prophet or whoever speaks something, they don't go and research what they say. Do it match what he says. And you, I agree. Agree with what? You can't say you agree when you don't know what he's saying and what source he's coming from.
Amen.
You got to know the source. You got to know the source. I see you. See me doing well. Oh, I see you. Oh, oops, I see an accident. You better watch folks who always prophesize in debt. Dead from God. Oh, I saw you dead. Oh, I saw a funeral. Oh, I saw a casket. And you were there. You saw the devil is alive.
Amen.
You ain't saw me. Because I'm not going in no casket.
Amen.
It is not my time to go.
Amen.
So you ain't saw me. What happened when a person comes and says, I saw destruction, and you do nothing with it, then destruction comes.
That's it.
But you got to bring it in the light of the Word of God. Somebody say, bring it in the light of the Word of God. Everything that a minister say, he must be able to back up what he say by scriptures. Hallelujah. That means that Paul told Timothy, he said, Timothy, preach the word in season and out of season.
Amen.
What he said, preach scriptures. Preach scriptures in season when they want to hear it, and preach scriptures when they don't want to hear it. The word. So anytime you have the spirit of discernment, you know who's teaching the word.
Amen.
Because why? You want to study and you have the information in your spirit. And I'm not receiving this.
Amen.
This ain't from God.
Amen.
It ain't from God. Amen. The enemy warned me to believe it so he can deceive me and get it to come to pass. Amen. Somebody said the devil's a liar.
The devil's a liar.
I remember many years ago, this minister, he's a minister, brother, I don't know. Only God knows. He came to the church. He visited him and his wife and for a long time. And then after service, then he came to me and said, Pastor, I see you being a bishop in 5 years. I say, no disrespect, my brother, that ain't from God. Because number one, the scripture says he that desire an office of a bishop, and I don't desire no office of a bishop. So that ain't for me. I'm not trying to be no bishop. I want to be. I don't desire. You have to desire the offer for a bishop.
That's the word.
So he said 5 years. It ain't from God. Because God don't miss. God never miss.
Amen.
See, once I have a desire, then God brings the word.
Amen.
To back up what I desire. So the spirit of discernment is discerning every word you hear. Amen. I'm telling you, just don't be so excited, so quick. I watch this person in the Apostolic Church in the Pentecostal. Oh, it's the Lord. Oh, he preaching. What are you preaching? Brimstone and fire. God, everybody is the fire God. And nobody understand what the man said. The man can be saying stupid. He said, praise the Lord, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Because he preaches so fast, you don't even understand. Go preach up. And the preacher, you're going to hell. Go preach up, preach. You have been overwhelmed by your excitement. And the preacher is not preaching the word. You gotta listen. Those who has been taught well, now. You see what's happening? Thank you, Jesus. They are discerning. They are listening, line upon line, precept upon precept. Amen. Heal it, deal it. And then they scope it out. What source is operating through her?
Jesus.
So when they stand up and they say, hallelujah, they see it.
Yes.
Amen. So it takes them a while to pinpoint.
Yes.
Don't come here.
Amen.
Because you already know what's been said, you already know what's going on in there.
Yes.
You got to pick up the spirit that operates in the environment that where you are. You gotta discern the spirits. That's why I call the discerning of spirits. You gotta discern the spirits that are operating in that region. You can't be so excited to believe something because it sounds good. How many of us, oh God, like good song? Come on, keep on praying. Where the drummer? Come on, I like good song. Come on, give me one of those keys. Come on, drummer, bring. Then I say, oh, God moving. God ain't moving. The keyboard display and the drum moving. The spirit of God ain't moving. And if the drum moving you got problem. If you're not moved by the spirit, that means you're picking up the wrong spirit. Just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
amen.
Do you got the right spirit in you? Do you got the right spirit in you? And how do you know when you got the right spirit and or the wrong spirit? Well, we dealing with some spirits. How do I know if a spirit is operating in me? Well, Pastor, I'm a Christian.
Yeah.
The devil says he's a Christian. He gets up for hell.
Yes.
The Bible tells us that Satan can transform himself as a what?
Angel of light.
And that they say, his ministers. That those who follow him can transform themselves as an angel of light. They're not the angel of light, but they transform themselves. They look like light. And if you don't know the difference, you'll be deceived. I said, if you don't know the difference, you'll be deceived. Some of your church people go to church and they go to church and you ask them, what's going on in church? Oh, the choir was good. And what happened? Oh, my God, the Holy Ghost just fall when the choir began to sing. What happened? Oh, that keyboard player, he's gifted. Nothing about Jesus, nothing about the word. After the worshipers sing, even though they sing a song that gives God glory, you still need the word of God.
Amen.
Because the Bible says that heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall abide forever. I don't care how good the choir is, I need the preacher to come preach to me. I need the word. I'm going to a whole week. Why, you can go to the week singing? You can sing the whole week? It's going to take the word. It is written. If you are going to overcome the situation in that week, it will inquire the word. Not a good song. And songs is good. It's good to worship. Well, you after worship, you better look for the preacher to come on. Some folks want to caught up in the worship and they say, well, it was God's will now for we just worship him because God know now we need to worship him. God said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. See, it is his word. You need to get his word. Yes, you worship him, but the more the word get in you, the more you'll learn and know how to worship him. Because whatever you worship, whatever you sing, must be a identifying what he said. Amen. Hallelujah. So we can discern. We've got to discern. Even the songs that we listen to will be called gospel songs. Some of those songs that we listen to, they got a gospel, but they ain't no gospel.
No.
Why are you looking at me funny?
That's true.
I know they got the label gospel, but they ain't no gospel.
That's true, man.
They is to bring you and suck you right into it. They're not gospel. They are displaying the world.
That's true.
With a little bit of Lord, anything can be a Lord. So what happened to church now? Identifying gifts, but not the anointing. You've been moved by a gift, but it is the anointing that is going to set you free. A person don't need to be born again to sing the gospel song. They'll sing and they'll chandelier drop.
That's cool, Pastor.
You say, well, that woman can sing. Aren't she anointed?
No.
What happened when she sang? Did people who had bondage was free and delivered from their bondage? That's what the anointing do. It brings deliverance. It brings freedom. It loops you. You can't be anointed and be bound. When you are anointed, you are able to loose other people.
Amen.
So we're not just gonna just get hype up with the song and hype up. Oh, that's my favorite song. Come on, sing my favorite song. Sing my favorite song. And get mad because the worship leader ain't sing your favorite song. Your favorite song. You can have a favorite song and still go to a test and lose. Because you ain't gonna go to bed singing, you ain't gonna wake up singing, you ain't gonna go to your whole day singing. Who go to the whole day singing? When the devil tell you, oh, this is the day that the Lord has made, and the devil hit you from the, this is the day that the Lord has made. You don't go to one night. You need the word. You need the word of God. You need the word of God. In order to survive the things that we're going through right now, in order to be a great and a disciplined Christian, one must submit themselves to the will of God.
Amen.
You've got to submit yourself to the will of God. Amen. You know what? I believe that if the church begin to get hungry again, hungry for understanding, for knowledge.
Yes.
I believe that every time we come here, it won't even take a big time for the move of God. God begin to manifest, because God will only manifest according to the level of your faith.
Yes.
You can decide today whether you want God to do anything for you. You can decide it. Whether you want God to do something or whether you don't want God to do anything. The blind man had to cry out. His faith was responding. He cried out. He cried out, thou son of David, have mercy upon me. He cried out. There was a what? Respond. He identified. This blind man had the spirit of discernment. He couldn't see in the natural. But in the spiritual, he was able to see. A lot of us seen in the natural, but he ain't seen in the spiritual.
That's true.
You see your problems, you see the opposition, you see everything negative that the devil wants you to see, but you can't see your way maker. We sing the song. But do we really know him? When you know him, you don't complain when you face with opposition. When you know Jesus, no negative word comes out of your mouth. I don't care how much pressure the enemy has applied on you. Because I understand and know that he that is in me is greater
than he that is in the world.
You know it. So nothing will be able to stop you. Because why? You know without a doubt that I have a creator living inside of me. And some things you might not understand right there, but you keep on holding on. You keep on holding on. You keep on holding on. You keep on believing. You keep on speaking the word of God. Don't get to the place.